Would you like to learn about the Cloud Architect team or the team of people that are responsible to design a cloud architecture? If so, this video is for you. Hi, my name is Mike Gibbs, and I've been an IT architect now for over 25 years. And after leading architecture projects for decades now, I wanted to share the Cloud Architect team because I think it'll help you understand the process to design an architecture better, or at least from the technology perspective, and why it's not like a certification. So let's say we're going to migrate an enterprise to a cloud, or at least a partial migration. Let's talk about what we normally have. We normally have 200 to 1,000 different applications, and those applications are from hundreds of vendors. So imagine trying to learn 500 different applications, the strengths and weaknesses and limitations of the current applications, which we need to know long before we can even figure out the kinds of applications that will better suit their business needs in the future. Because we need to know what's working and what's not. So assume hundreds of different applications. Also, while you're at it, assume that the business is located in 4 or 5 different continents and has and will continue to have systems in 4 or 5 different continents. That they may have 100,000 plus IP addresses out there and thousands of routes in the routing table. And if any of that goes wrong, the business's functions will cease. And they may have petabytes of data and hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of vendors. So when we get a situation like that, which is the only kind of architectures I've ever worked with in my entire life, and that's what a cloud architect is typically going to be dealing with, is enterprise customers. When it comes to the time to migrate something, we have to be aware of these common things. In 98% of the cases, we're still going to have a multi-cloud environment. So what does that mean? It means we need to be focused, or at least having some knowledge of every different cloud out there. Public clouds like AWS, Azure, and Google. Private clouds like Nutanix or OpenStack. So there's that. Now, it also means we need to have an understanding of networking. And people dedicate their lives to networking, but we still need to have some reasonable knowledge of networking. We need to have some knowledge of security, at least reasonable knowledge of security, some knowledge of big data, some knowledge of application architecture, some knowledge of database architecture, and even some knowledge of AI architecture. I want you to think about that. Any one of those careers would probably take 25 years to really master. So now we've got a person that needs to be responsible for something that is, realistically speaking, impossible. So you as an architect, you're going to have to build a team. On your team, let's say you've got a migration, you're going to have a network architect with you. Because if you don't, and you get anything from the IP addressing to the routing wrong, the entire system will collapse. So as you try to plan a migration and you're the lead cloud architect, you're going to have to need some network architects to actually assist you on the networking, because the networking can get very complicated. Now, we also have to think security. And security is not just a couple of access listed security groups in enterprise security. We are talking about demilitarized zones that will exist out there for remote access versus web type applications. We're going to be dealing with SIEM systems and data loss prevention systems and end-to-end security policy. We're going to need to be thinking about incident response and disaster and business continuity planning. So we're going to need to have some security architects on our team and people that focus on that. Now, data is the new gold, but only if it's used correctly. And it takes a lot to design a proper big data environment to make sure that the organization is using the right technology and cleaning their data and has good data hygiene practices, etc. So typically speaking, we're going to have a big data architect because businesses want to learn from their data and do better things. Now, while we're at that with our big data architects, we're probably going to have an artificial intelligence architect too, to look at all the organization's AI. It could be generative AI, it could be traditional machine learning and forecasting and recommendation. It could be a lot of different things that we're using, but we're going to have an AI architect in pretty much every architecture we're going to be working with. Now, if we're focused on all these things, what about these applications? We've got hundreds of them, remember? So that means we're going to need to have good application architects and people that truly understand applications. And databases, you know, well, you even need database architects. And there's going to be other architects we're also going to need. Now, when we're designing these systems and we're working with all those architects, they're going to need to go out there and reach out to various vendors and work with some engineering teams as well to help give you guidance and feedback. So that means on our architecture team, we're going to have some cloud engineers. Why? They're the people that build these things. They're going to be experts at what they do, and they're going to be more tech focused than the architect that's more business focused. We're also going to need DevOps engineers too, because they're going to help build and automate a lot of this technology. And we architects aren't DevOps people. We can't focus on their job, but we still need them. So we'll have DevOps engineers. Now, we've got all these applications, and the application architects are going to need someone that's going to get deeper under the nitty-gritty to go figure out how to do these integrations, migrations, look at the code. And that's why we're going to have some developers on our team as well. Now, we'll have some network engineers, the people that are going to make those networking changes at some point, or recommend the deep tech in the network wise. And again, that's why we need network engineers. And now we're going to need some people along with the build out to be able to build these things and set up the firewalls and the firewall rules, for example, in the IDS and the IPS system and the data loss prevention. So that means we're going to need security engineers on our team and data scientists for the big data. So as you can see, we need a lot of people. So when you build this type of an architecture team and you're planning a migration like we just talked about, expect this migration process and this architecture team to be busy full time for potentially 1 to 3 months just on this, on the design of the redesign. So I hope that kind of makes sense to you why we need a cloud architecture team. And why is this? Well, we have to get this deep because if our focus is going to be on the business and what technology systems as cloud architects or enterprise architects will help that business and what business processes or how we want that business to operate will further optimize that business and how technology can optimize those processes. That's our job. And unfortunately, where you focus is what you do. So as architects, we focus on business outcomes. But we're sure going to need all those technology people to make our architecture team work and to make our architectures work. So that's why you need such good leadership skills as an architect. That's why you need such good communication skills as an architect, because you're going to be having these conversations and leading these teams on a daily basis. This is why you have to have high levels of emotional intelligence, because in a project like this, you know, there's going to be conflict and you have to diffuse that conflict and bring out the best in everyone. So now I hope you understand the point of the cloud architecture team and why we cloud architects are busy with these types of things. And that's why we can't afford to be hands-on professionals. If you've enjoyed this video and desire a career in cloud architecture or enterprise architecture, join us for a free webinar or a free ebook. They're listed in the description of this video. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell to be notified of new videos to assist you with your technology career. This is Mike Gibbs signing off for now. I'll see you soon.